So hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Harshit Kumar of class 6B, and in this video I will start my chapter summary, that is the food, where does it comes from. It is based on the CBSC book of science. So let's start it. My first topic I choose is the food variety, and food variety. Now let's start it. So, food variety. I will write it here, okay? Food variety. Food variety, okay? So, in the food variety, there are millions of such plant-based or animal-based products we can find. They're the foods that we eat regularly in our daily lives. So, for example, the dal we eat always, rice, chapati, etc. So this was the food variety. Now let's start it from the food ingredients. So food ingredients. Food ingredients. The things needed for making a food so that it get more tastier and more enjoyable for us, so that is known as the food ingredients. Food ingredients, okay? Let's list down the food ingredients of some foods. So let's take the dal, okay, easy one. So dal, to make the dal we need these types of food ingredients. So first is the obviously dal, okay. On the next we have water, and other type of spices that our mother usually used to make dals more tastier, spices, okay. So these are the things needed to make dals, okay. These are known as the ingredients. Okay, ingredients, these are known as the ingredients that are needed for a food to be made. So on next we have the autotrophs and the heterotrophs. Autotrophs and the heterotrophs, now I will tell the definition of it. So first, autotrophs. Okay, autotrophs are the living organisms that make their food by their own. For example, we will take the plants. It's the best example for it, because only plants are able to make their own food, not us. So the autotrophs definition that I have told, that the plants that make their own food by using sunlight, carbon dioxide, water, etc., is known as the autotrophs. Okay, now on the other we have heterotrophs. They are the opposite of this. Heterotrophs, okay, they are the opposite of the autotrophs, because the heterotrophs are the living organisms that are not able to make their own food. For example, like we as humans beings, animals, etc., cannot make their own food. But to get their food, they hunt animals that they need, and they can digest it or other the plant products. Okay, so for the best example we take humans. Humans, okay, humans are the best examples of heterotrophs. Okay, so this was the autotrophs and heterotrophs definitions. Now, types of heterotrophs. So before that, we will start it. So let's start the type of heterotrophs. Before that, I have to rub the board so that there come space and you can understand it much easier. So I will erase the ingredients, foods ingredients, and the dals ingredients that are needed to make food. Okay, so now we are talking about the types of heterotrophs. Types of heterotrophs. You have listened this many times. They are the herbivores, let's start from there. There are more types. Before telling that, I will tell the definition of herbivores. The animals or the living organisms that eats only the plant product. The plant products mean the things that comes from plant and you eat by cooking it. So heterotrophs only eat plants. For example, the cows, they only eat grass, and they have a teeth that is blunt. Okay, blunt means fully flat from the above. So for the cow is the best example for the herbivore. So herbivore, now we have completed the herbivore definitions. Let's on the next, that is the carnivores are the animals or living organisms that eats only animal products. For example, let's take lion. So lion eats only the meat of the other animals. So lions only eat the meat, not the grass, because they do not like it. There is a choice for every living organisms to eat their own food. Okay, so lions have very sharp teeth to tear the meat of the animals. So this was the carnivores. Now on the other hand, we have the omnivores. Omnivores are the animals that are the mixture of herbivore and the carnivores, because in the omnivores, the animals or the living organisms eat both the plant and animal product. For example, humans, it is the best example because humans are the very best examples of the omnivores, because human eats both meat or animal product or plant product. So human, they have different types of teeth for tearing the meat, for grinding it, to cut it, etc. So these were the omnivores. Now the main fact I will tell you is the scavengers. Okay, scavengers. So before that, I have to erase it up because there is no space to write it. Okay, if you having any problem, so please note it down, the things that I have told you. So I will erase the carnivore and the omnivores, herbivores, examples and the topic. So now we have the scavengers. 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 Okay, if you do not able to remind it always time, so always broke the words that are difficult for you, that scavengers, like in Avengers, Vengers. So scavengers, the animals who have that eat the meat that are dead for a while. Means for a vulture, vulture are the birds that eat a dead or an dead animals that is bitten by or attacked by another animals. And bears are also the good examples of it. So this was the scavengers and the scavengers, herbivores, carnivores, and the omnivores, and the plant variety. So thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment my video.